Hello everyone, I'm back and I'm so excited because it's time to take the geode out of the mold. And I'm starting with the outer barrier. I'm trying to peel it off. And it looks that it goes very easy. But yeah, you never know. So very carefully I'm peeling the outer barrier of the geode. Yeah, and in some places it seemed that it's a little bit stuck. So the silicon that is loose, that I take it away. And I'm trying to lift it a little bit to see if it comes off the plastic. And then starting at the inner barrier to get it loose. Yes, and also this geode is out of the mold and also within 2 minutes. So, the silicon works really well. And now I'm looking at the sides, because it also was a test if I had sharp edges. And most of the edges are okay, but in some places the resin leaked under the silicon. So you can see, I show it to you. There also in the black. So if you want to do a freeform geode with silicon, make sure that the silicon is very good on your plastic, that it doesn't leak. But the edges are mainly very smooth, not what I had with the blue geode, that I need to sand it all the way around. Only now in this geode a few places where it leaked under the silicon. So I'm checking the back. But overall it looks very good. I'm peeling off the little parts where it leaked. There also where the fire glass is also leaked. And also the last layer, I have a sharp edge standing up. So that needs to come off. So the top coat will be after this. Also the back, not so much wrinkles, but not as shiny as I would have liked it. So after this I'm going to sand those parts off where it leaked, and also a sharp edge of the last layer. And if I've done that, then I will clean it with alcohol and I will tape the back and do a top coat so that I have nice edges, edges. But overall, I'm very pleased how this comes out of the mold. Yes, what I already said is that I had a sharp edge on the last layer I did, and I don't think we can prevent that with a silicone mold. So I'm doing the top coat when it's out of the mold. So I need to tape the back, so what you can see, because I don't want any drips on the back. And yeah, I'm using normal masking tape, and first I'm gonna tape all the way around. And it's very hard to tape when you have gloves on, because the tape also sticks to your gloves. But yeah, I don't want any fingerprints on the resin. And I always do a top coat, so that is no problem if it's out of the mold. Normally I do it when it's in the mold, but now I'm going to do it out of the mold, so yeah. So I'm pressing the tape onto the geode, and now I'm removing the masking tape along the edge of the geode with a very sharp knife. And I always use this masking tape, and I don't have any problems with that it sticks on the resin, or that I don't get the drips off. It works very well. So all the way around I'm removing the masking tape. Almost done. Yeah, more masking tape, because I want to make sure that when I lift it with my gloves, because you have resin on your gloves, that I don't have the resin that comes off your gloves on the back of the geode. So I'm adding more masking tape. And I must say, I have so much fun making these geodes. I really like it. So the next one will also be a geode, next video. But then what I already mentioned on a acetate sheet, because that is heat resistant. And I want to test if it works well. And also if it comes out of the mold when I use the acetate sheet, if it's shiny on the back. I don't know yet, so I'm going to test that. Now I'm going along the sides with my scissors, and I'm pressing very hard onto the geode, because I don't want any resin leaking under the masking tape. So all the way around I'm pressing the masking tape very tight, hard to the geode. Yes, I'm going to start with the clear coat. I made sure that that it's level, the geode, and because otherwise the resin will slide to one side, and I don't want that. So I'm pouring the resin on top of the geode, all the way around. And the geode has now, with this top coat, 5 layers, so it's rather thick. I like that. And also in my videos I mentioned how many resin I used. So if you want to know that, then you need to look at the slide where I list all the materials. Behind the resin I mention also how many milliliters I use for each layer. Now with the silicon spatula I'm making sure that I also have the resin on the edges. And I'm looking at it from all directions, because then I can see if I missed a spot somewhere. Making sure that the resin flows over the sides. Yeah, and also from this geode I want to make a table. I already ordered the table legs. And also when I attach the table legs I will make a video of it. Because I'm thinking about how I will do that. But I will make a video of it and you can all see how I attach them to the geode. Now I'm using the torch to get rid of all the air bubbles. And at the end of this video also the end result, where I show it in a light, because yeah, I don't think the light will shine that through, because I used also opaque colors. But yeah, I will show it in a light and in the sun, see how it sparkles. But then you need to wait until the end of this video. And this is the end result. So first a close-up video from the sun that shines on top of it, so you can see it sparkle. And yeah, I'm very happy with it, because you can see all the different layers, because the glitter line, the glitter I did in the first and in the second layer, and the blue I did in the last layer. So you can see all the different layers, also the lines that I placed on different layers. But yeah, you can't see it in the video, because the videos are 2D always. And yes, this is 3D, so yeah, I can't help it. But I'm very happy with this piece. Looks very nice, very sparkly. Also, the colors are very bright. A little bit difficult to film in the sun, but I do my best. So there you see the gold and the blue that I did in the last layer. Very nice. And the green glitter that shines through. Also the acrylic lines that I did last, the dark blue and the gold. Up close the fire glass and the nice green, sparkles a lot. Yes, I like this. There's also the pink that I did in the first layer. Also in this video, a up close video of the light that shines through, so then you need to wait if you want to see that. Overall look. So, and this is how it looks like when the light shines through. What I already said is that I used also opaque colors, so the light doesn't shine through those colors, but so you can see in the green and some parts of the gold and the blue and the pink, you can see the light shining through, and also through the fire glass. Looks very nice, but so difficult to film. A little bit closer. There are the glitter lines, the blue and the green ones. Looks very good. There you see the pink with the fire glass. So I want to thank you all for watching this video and the whole series of this geode. And if you like my videos, please subscribe to my channel. If you have questions or comments, place them under the video. My next test will be with an acetate sheet. I'm also making a geode on that one. And if you want to see that, then hit the little bell, then you get notified. And I will see you in the next video. Bye!